Let me introduce Mr. Dave Grusin. Please welcome Dave.
Trying to anticipate what we need to do that's coming up.
Right now, I just want to go to the pickups of bar 55.
All the time, your mother said, why don't you smile when you play, you know? It never really took. If I'm thinking about smiling, I'm not thinking about what I'm supposed to be doing.
Bernstein's music was part of why it was so successful and sounded so fresh, is that coming at it from a position of a classical composer who actually turned out to be a real talented guy at writing musicals, I much admire people like Dave who can take classics and do something new and fresh with them. That's a great formula for connecting with an audience.
Thank you.
Jerry.
Beautiful, man.
You might imagine that we were having fun up here. You'd be right. We're going to bring out, he's huge all over the world. I mean, seriously, internationally. His name is John Cicada.
Sound I ever heard. Maria, 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 Maria. All the beautiful sounds of the world in a single word. Maria, 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 Maria. I've just met a girl named Maria, and suddenly the name will never be the same to me. Maria, I just kissed a girl named Maria, and suddenly I found how wonderful the sound can be. Say it soft, and it's almost like praying. Maria, I'll never stop saying Maria. Stop saying Maria. Maria.
Dave Grusin. Right now, I'm going to bring out somebody who, she's not my goddaughter, she's not my granddaughter, she's not my daughter. I don't know how we're related, but I've known her since she's 4 or 5 years old, and sort of stayed in touch with her through the years, and it seems like I've known her forever. Incredible singer, one of my favorite people in the world. Miss Patty Austin.
Hi, everybody. So here's the deal. You know, Dave has written a lot of music for a lot of movies, and one of my favorite Davey movies is a movie that starred a guy that makes women swoon, even still, even though he plays really weird parts now, Jeff Bridges. Right? Still a sexy little fella. And then there's this woman named Michelle Pfeiffer. Is that Michelle? Michelle, I told you about squeaking in these concert halls. So Michelle did this fabulous number in the Fabulous Baker Boys. You cannot ever forget this number, right? And she slithered about the piano in a red dress. Well, I don't have a red dress and I can't slither. No. I refuse to slither. I'm too old to slither. But I can tell you this tale based upon the song that she sang. We're going to do the complete lyric. I will just tell you, listen hard to this lyric. I certainly wish that Tiger Woods had. Here we go. Work with me, people. Work with me. Another bride, another groom, another sunny honeymoon, another season, another reason for making whoopee. A lot of shoes, a lot of rice. The groom's so nervous, he answers twice. I do. It's really killing that he's so willing to make some whoopee. Now, picture a little love nest down where the road is clean. Picture that same sweet love nest. Think what a year can bring. He's washing dishes and baby clothes. He's so ambitious, he even sews. But don't forget, folks, that's what you get, folks, for making whoopee. Another year, or maybe less. What is this I hear? Oh, can't you guess? She feels neglected, and he's suspected of making whoopee. She sits at home alone most every night. He doesn't phone, email, tweet her all right. It's really killing. He's so willing. He says he's busy. She says, is he? He says, no. Well, maybe he's making whoopee. He doesn't make much money. Only $5 billion per. Judge Judy thinks she's funny. She says, you'll give six to her. He says, now, judge, what if I fail? The judge says, ha, 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 right into jail. So don't forget, folks, that's what you get, folks, for making whoopee. Tiger, you should have heard me way back when you married that girl in 1993, making whoopee. Making, and I'm not talking about Goldberg, whoopee.
Really good friend of mine, Mr. Nestor Torres.
Basically, Dave Grusin is crazy. Just taking this one beautiful, poignant piece and the 3/4, and then out of nowhere, he throws in this like hardcore piano Latin montuno. Thank you.
The name of the song is I Feel Pretty, and when you hear Nestor play like that, you almost do feel pretty. We're going to play a couple of Gershwin pieces. And I guess my nostalgia about Gershwin was when I was growing up, my mother was sort of a piano player. I started taking lessons when I was very young, but she had on the piano, as far back as I can remember, sheet music to Summertime, which was from Porgy and Bess. And I remember what it looked like. I remember the graphics there and so forth. George Gershwin, Ira Gershwin. But I'm going to play a medley of two of those fantastic themes from Porgy and Bess. Bess, You Was My Woman, and I Loved You, Porgy.
I tell you, the human element is what really makes it fun. especially live with real people as opposed to synthesizer and sample instruments and so forth. There's nothing like a string section that's actually making all that air vibrate around them, you know, when you're right there. It's great.
And Dave and I and Quincy and all—it's funny because we're all kind of from the same club. Phil Ramone, Larry Rosen—we all came up in a time when you made music. You didn't say, oh, "We're going to do something for a theater tonight," and "Oh my God, we're doing some jazz," and then we're going to do some bebop, and then we're going to do a classical. No, you're going to make some music. time. I've been passing time, watching trains go by all of my life. I'm lying on the sand, watching seabirds fly, wishing there could be someone waiting home for me. Something's telling me it might be you. It's telling me it might be all of my life. I'm looking back as lovers go walking past all of my life. I'm wondering how they met and what makes it last. If I found the place, would I recognize the face? Something's telling me it might be you. It's telling me it might be you. So many quiet walks to take, so many dreams to wake, and there's so much love to make. I think we're gonna need some time. All we really need is time. And it's telling me it might be you all of my life. I've been singing love songs and lullabies, and there's so much more. No one's ever heard me sing, ever heard. Something's telling me it might be you. It's telling me it might be you. Waiting for.
Patty Austin.
Yes, indeed. We'll be back.
Here's an idea about the geography of a score. There was so much beautiful scenery in this picture. I knew I had to come up with something that felt like that area. What is New England music? All I could think about was sort of Protestant hymn harmonies. They are sort of that simple, you know, like a hymn.
Film scoring is you're by yourself, you're huddled up in a dark room somewhere trying to finish this stuff. And you don't see anybody until you get to the date. And then there are all your friends and they're all playing it. And it's an amazing time.
Please welcome back Miss Patty Austin and Mr. John Sicardo.
A place for us somewhere, a place for us, peace and quiet and open air, wait for us somewhere.
There's a time for us somewhere, a time for us,
time together with time to share, time to learn, time.
I think both of you, or either of you, have a career in this business.
We have somebody here with us tonight. Her name is Monica Manzini.
Thank you. Dave, would you like to do something?
Well, this is a stab in the dark here. I was just wondering if you'd be willing to sing one of your dad's tunes. I don't know. Would you like to do that?
It would be my pleasure.
Before I totally forget about it, I want to pay special thanks to this unbelievable orchestra, the Henry Manzini Institute Orchestra.
Imagination in music is the artistry of imagination.
Dave is
just a great interpreter of song. He brings something to the party that just is unexpected.
get a song like America, and then you hear it by Dave Grusin, and you made it much hipper.
The more we talk about this work, the more in awe I am of it.
Dave has an effect on anything he does because he's Dave Grusin, for heaven's sakes, people. Don't you know that by now?
It's the people in back of me, it's the musicians, to be there live while they're actually creating these sounds. In general, that's the focal point for me.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Dave Grusin.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Mr. Patty Austin. John Cicada. Monica Mancini. Nessa Torre. Gary Burton. Arturo Sandoval. Sammy Figueroa. Greg Field. The Mancini Orchestra. The Four Singers.
Thank you, Jazz Roots.
Level of professionalism to pull something off like this is really extraordinary, and it's about experience. There aren't that many people that could do it.
Wow. You know, this guy wrote this stuff.
Thank you.